Techno Update. Subscribe now. Huawei Honor 7X. Honor has previously blown us away with what it can put in cheaper handsets, and the Honor 7X has made another leap forward by bringing an elongated 18:9 bezel-less display to the mid-range market for the first time. This is especially surprising as the Honor 9, which the company launched earlier this year, still has a standard 16:9 display, unlike most other flagship devices this year. The Honor 7X features a fully metal design that's attractive, although the back of the phone is flat, so it doesn't sit in the hand as comfortably as the Honor 6X did. It does make it thinner than a lot of other popular phones, at 4.6 millimeters, and if you're looking for a slimline device, this is an appealing option. The back panel is metal, but it doesn't have the same close to high-end feel as, say, the Nokia 6. Despite the overall finish on the Honor 7X, the metal doesn't feel as satisfying as when you're holding the glass-backed Honor 9. The fingerprint sensor is located on the rear or the handset, and we found it easy to reach when holding the phone. Battery life is always a big consideration for your next phone, and you'll be glad to know the Honor 7X offers solid performance that matches a lot of competing phones. It's not game-changing, but considering the phone uses a fairly average 3,340 mAh cell and there is a large screen on the front of the phone drawing plenty of power, we've even quite surprised with how good the life has been. In general use we found the Honor 7X would happily last a full day, but if you're going to be using your phone a little more intensively you may find you need to give it a boost partway through the day. Even with normal usage you'd struggle to get the Honor 7X to last more than a day though, so expect to recharge this phone overnight. If you're looking for a cheap device with stronger battery life you may want to opt for the Moto E4 Plus, which we found would last 2 days with average usage. There's a dual camera setup on the rear of the Honor 7X, with a 16MP sensor doing most of the heavy lifting and a 2MP sensor to the side of it which is dedicated to depth sensing. In good lighting you'll be happy with the images Honor 7X can deliver. For most photography you'll be using just this primary lens, and we felt it was good at focusing and taking a photo, although it could sometimes be a little slow. The Honor 7X uses the company's own Motion UI 5.1 software, which provides a skin over the top of Android 7 Nougat. We've yet to learn when the phone will get upgraded to Android 8 Oreo, but we've asked Honor and hopefully we'll hear more soon. Right now Android 7 software is okay, but it's last year's release, and it'll quickly start to feel dated if the phone isn't upgraded soon. The larger screen ratio on the Honor 7X makes it great for watching movies, but with some video apps you'll need to press the full screen display button mentioned earlier to get the whole picture on the screen. Once you've done that, you retreat it to a big screen for watching video without having to grapple with a relatively large and unwieldy phone. Despite the screen only being full HD, the picture quality and vivid images make this a great phone to watch video on, especially for a mid-range device. Inside the Honor 7X there's a Kirin 659 chipset and 4GB of RAM, which is enough to run most games and apps smoothly. The 7X runs a little slower and not at such high quality as most flagship phones, but we found it was able to cope with everything we wanted to do on a daily basis. We ran the phone through Geekbench 4, and it scored an average of 3,579, which is an improvement on the score of 3,105 that the Honor 6X achieved. That's a poor score, however, when compared to the Moto G5S Plus, which is a similar phone in terms of specs. The G5S Plus is a touch more expensive, but it came out with a score of 4,312, which would make that phone a better choice. choice if you're planning to do lots of intensive tasks and gaming every day. The Honor 7X has the makings of a great mid-range phone, and everything adds up to a useful package that can do most things you'll need it to.